very excited to undo this, but I think it's gonna spring back considerably. Still a lot of spring in it. Not sure what to do. So you can see how much it's springed back out of shape after leaving it overnight in those clamps, but yeah, I'm gonna have to maybe anneal the aluminum and try it again, or take out the form and somehow bend it past, you know, bend it past its point and hope it springs back to where I want it, which is probably easier to screw up, so I think I'm gonna try the annealing first. I'll sort out this seam first before I do that, and we shall see. This is how much it undid out of the clamps. That's gonna make a difference, but I'm gonna let it sit and start on the neck. So this homemade jig failed miserably. That. Not good. Then I had an idea. Yeah. Pocketable jig. It's almost the perfect angle. It's insane. Who would have thought? Has anyone ever used a pocket hole in aluminum? Let's see if it works. Changed a bit, borrowed the color. No. Okay, I'm gonna try the easiest option. Do a line, and I'm gonna eyeball it. Pocket hole jig was a complete failure, but basically I made two pocket holes. Not pretty, but they'll work. Well, I hope. We'll see. not easy, but it worked. Try without the form. Go a little bit past the shape here. Hopefully it doesn't explode or something. Don't like that. Well, it only took like 3 hours. And look at that finish. Who even needs a bridge board? Deep here where the screw is, so I have to fill that. So I was originally going to try to braise the body, like the neck, but that's just too much heat and it will warp. So I found this low heat solder, this low temperature solder with this flux, and it should work great without too much heat. Neck is looking great. Loving the little volute. A little bit aggressive with the grinder here. So I'm gonna try to fill it with some solder and see if I can build that back up. So this is my fretboard material. It's actually a recycled paper product. It's called Richlite, I believe. And they sell fretboard blanks. The typical fretboard wood, like a ebony that this replaces, is like super endangered. And there aren't like many real ethical sources. So this is a nice alternative and sustainable. A lot of guitar manufacturers, we use ebony fretboards. It's really hard to get like an even black ebony, because that's from like older trees apparently, or something like that. So what they do is they'll get ebony that's like an inconsistent color, like I'll have variations, and they'll just stain it black. Like, what's the point of cutting down an endangered tree to then stain it? It makes no sense. It's got a nice depth to it too. It's not just like a flat, like a plastic. Got some warmth. Okay, so I noticed that my 10th fret is in the wrong position, just by a hair. So starting over. Some gaps there. Going to have to fill with epoxy. Thank you. I have no idea how to play this. A bit tinny. So the action's a little bit high and the intonation's a little bit off, but overall I think it sounds pretty good. It's very resonant, loud. Yeah, I don't know how to play, obviously, but I'm very happy with it. Sounds great.
It's not the destination, but the jigs you make along the way.